Can you like the movie? Ends with a scene of a city in disrepair. The city was destroyed and no human was visible means the city was deserted as dangerous radiation was spread in the city. Everyone died as a result of the radiation, and the survivors are having a more difficult time with it. A girl named Anna is shown in the next scene going to the city while wearing a protective suit for bringing some vital stuff. After bringing things she returns home and reaching near the home she takes off her suit because the area where Anna lived was safe because it was surrounded by mountains and forest. Reaching home, Anna cleans her body and takes a shower so if there will be any radiation that will be removed. Anna sleeps after doing this. The next day, Anna goes to see the trap she fixed with her dog but she didn't find anything. There wasn't anything that will be used as her food. Suddenly, Anna's dog runs from there and Anna moves behind it. She reaches a strange car while chasing her dog. Meanwhile, her dog runs from there when it sees someone there. Anna hides at a place to see who is there that her dog ran after seeing him. Anna sees a man who comes near the car while wearing a suit named John. He checks radiation through his machine but he doesn't find any radiation here. John becomes happy because of it and removes his suit while shouting loudly. After it, John moves forward then Anna comes to his car as he leaves but her dog was dragging her with it. Anna moves behind it and finds John who was taking bath under the waterfall. Anna immediately runs to him and asks him to get out of the water and John gets scared and alert after seeing a gun in Anna's hand. He immediately picks up his gun and points it at her but Anna makes John understand I am not here to harm you. I am here for your betterment to forbid you not to take a bath here. She says this water is radioactive as it is coming from the city and John gets panicked hearing it. He obeys Anna and comes out of the water immediately. Until then the radiation was spread in his body due to it, John's condition gets worse and he starts vomiting. John comes near his car and takes out an injection then he was trying to inject it. He can't inject the injection. Then Anna helps him in this later, she brings John near her home and cleans her while throwing water at him. After it, she brings John inside the home but his condition was still not well. Anna brings medicine for John and gives it to him even then his condition didn't get well and got worse gradually. Anna takes care of him then Anna comes at night to see John and finds that he has a high temperature. He was in a lot of pain, so Anna applied cold water bandages on him. Even then the next day when he wasn't in his senses and wasn't getting well Anna becomes worried. She prays for John's health with a pure heart. Her prayer was accepted, and John was on the mend. Anna was talking to John while sitting with him in the evening and shows him a photo album. There was a picture of Anna's brother in it. And she tells John that I lived here with my father and brother. My father died because of radiation and then one day, my brother went to bring some important things. And he didn't return. He's gone missing, and I have no idea whether he's alive or dead, healthy or sick. Hearing this, John becomes depressed and begins staring at Anna. John questions her when Anna was cultivating in the fields. And asks you have a tractor then why don't you use it? Why are you cultivating without it? Anna says we need fuel to drive the tractor. We don't have fuel. But hearing this, John says there is a gas station at a distance and we will bring fuel from there. Anna says there isn't any worker who will give me fuel. John replies you are living here for a long time even then you couldn't get fuel? Anna says after hearing this, don't worry I will bring fuel from somewhere soon. Anna moves and brings fuel then fills it in a can. Now John was watching Anna doing this from a distance. Anna thanks John reaching home and says I forgot this while living alone. That I can take out fuel myself. John says yes, we feel this while living alone because I also used to live alone in a bunker. I lived there alone like you. And I felt like my life wasn't going anywhere and came to a halt. I am an engineer so I thought no matter if I will die but I will move out of the bunker. I will spend a life of freedom. That's why I made that strange car and the suit to move out. Anna is shown the next day while fishing. And she catches a fish later, she cooks it and enjoys it with John. Then he comes to the waterfall. John says to Anna we have to make a huge wheel with the help of woods. And it will move as the water falls on it from the waterfall. It will help in turning on the generator and Anna likes John's idea and becomes happy. Now they return home and think to collect the woods. Meanwhile, John says we can make a huge wheel while breaking the church as we want, but Anna forbids him from doing this because this church was her support when she was alone. John explains to Anna that she won't need to go to church if she prays from the heart. Even then, he stops thinking to repair the generator so Anna will not feel bad. After it, Anna moves to do cultivation. Now John comes to a deserted supermarket and finds a few beer bottles. John starts drinking them while sitting there and drinks more when Anna arrives. And he was drunk, but Anna somehow brings John home. John was shouting at Anna and she moves from there being upset and angry. John brings breakfast for Anna the next morning and apologizes for misbehaving the last night. Anna says it's okay, I am not angry, just relax, after hearing his apology. The scene at night is shown where they were having a candlelight dinner. Suddenly, Anna starts drinking, even John forbids her from drinking. Even then she didn't hear him and drinks a lot. She became intoxicated and lost her senses. And she didn't know what is she saying or doing? She purposes John for marrying her being drunk. John, however, says while refusing her, that we have other concerns. We will think later about marrying. Anna agrees, and the next day, Anna was with her dog in the forest. Meanwhile, her dog stops near a man while running from her. Here we discover the man was named Caleb and he wasn't looking well, and asks for water from Anna as help. Anna brings him near her house for helping him and giving him water. John points the gun at Caleb seeing it, but Anna stops him to shoot and says he doesn't need anything from us and he just wants water. Anna helps Caleb and gives him water to drink. Here, Caleb tells them he was living in a cave with his friend at a distance. My companions died because of radiation and I move out from there to save my life. He asks to live with them for a few days and John allows him to stay outside the house. Anna says we should keep Caleb inside, so she brings Caleb inside the house. Caleb asks John while having food how did he come here? John says after hearing it, I was going toward the north and then a boy comes while running. He was younger and his condition was worse. The boy was trying to snatch my food. But his condition becomes worse within a short time because of radiation. After it, I come here while leaving him there. Anna shows Caleb his room after dinner. But John makes him understand, what are you doing? You don't know anything about him yet. It will be better for you to stay away from him. But Anna says, John, what are you saying? You are suspecting me? Now tell me why you didn't tell me about that boy? The boy who was infected with radiation and you left him alone to come here. John says, Anna, I wanted to tell you but I didn't collect the courage to tell you everything. Because you may not hear it. After hearing this, Anna becomes depressed and says, I lost my father, and my brother went missing. Now I have much courage after losing my family so I could hear it. John tells him everything after hearing it, that the boy was none other than her brother. But I shot and ended him. Anna becomes upset after knowing this and starts weeping. John apologizes for this and Anna forgives him. The next day, John moves with Caleb into the forest for hunting. And they bring an ostrich home after hunting it. They have the ostrich for dinner at night and discuss the wheel after it. Caleb says we can't break the church to make the wheel. And we should not do it because the church is a good place to pray. We shouldn't harm it. But this time, Anna says to John, you can do what you think is right. She says, I will support you. John agrees to break the church after hearing this from her. The next day, they start making the wheel after breaking the church. Anna and Caleb were getting close during this. They were becoming frank and John feels bad to see this. He calls Anna and makes her understand that he isn't getting hurt from what she is doing. Because this is your life, and you have the right to spend it with whomever you want. With me or with Caleb. Anna says, John, there is nothing like this, and leaves while weeping after saying this. The next day, it is shown and have candlelight dinner. And then come near the pond for enjoying. They play a game while moving inside the pond and Caleb throws a bottle in the water. Now John and Anna will find out the bottle on their turns, and firstly, John moves to find it. But he couldn't find it, then Anna moves in search of the bottle. Anna says, coming out of the water, I have found the bottle after a short time, but I didn't hold it and it just slipped from my hand. Caleb doesn't believe Anna. That's why he moves downside the water to check the bottle. John again feels bad to see this. John says to Anna that he is ready to get married when they come out of the water. And we should get married. They move to a room for discussion, but John sleeps because of being drunk. And Anna doesn't feel good, so she moves to Caleb and spends time with him. The scene next morning is shown where Anna was sitting at the breakfast table. And Caleb sits with her, and John once again feels bad. He feels something is wrong, but Anna doesn't sit there and leaves from there. Later, John and Caleb move for the last task of making the wheel. On the way, John says to Caleb, me and Anna become closer because of your arrival. Thanks for coming. But hearing this, Caleb says, John, you can't lie and you don't seem good while lying. Actually, the thing is, you didn't want me to come here ever. John doesn't answer him after hearing this. Well, after it, they go to make the wheel. Now their wheel was ready and they become happy to see the completion of hard work. Meanwhile, Caleb's foot slips when he was coming upside through rope after wearing the suit. John saves him while holding the rope. But they see in each other's eyes when Caleb's foot slips the second time. Caleb sees hate for himself in John's eyes. And understands immediately that John will not save him this time. Then the scene cuts. John returns home but alone. And Anna reveals in front of him that she has made a huge mistake last night. She says, I wasn't in my senses because of being drunk. So I spent time with Caleb, so forgive me, John. After hearing it, John says to Anna, no problem, Anna, I forgive you, so just relax. Caleb has returned with my suit after living so many days with us, and he also thanked us. Anna gets panicked after hearing this and suspects John. She comes out of the house and checks but doesn't find anyone. Due to it, Anna becomes depressed and suspects John. Perhaps John has done something to Caleb, and she will be sad for a few more days. After a few days, there was light in her house, as her house wiring was connected with the generator by John. Later, the generator was turned on with the help of the wheel. Now Anna becomes happy to see this. The next day, she comes to her house's store for taking some stuff and sees a piano. It was in the church before, but after breaking the church, John has placed it here. Anna starts playing the piano. Meanwhile, John arrives. Because of the way Anna was looking at John, we can conclude that Anna has discovered everything. John has ended Caleb, and her trust has been broken in her grief. Anna plays the piano after it. John could also hear the piano. The film ends with Anna's sadness and feelings.